Hello guys, in this video I am going to discuss with you how we can manage a teaching station in Player 2 examination. There are many teaching stations in Player 2 exam, and these include per speculum examination, basic life support, ECG teaching, knee examination, breast examination, antenatal examination, testicular examination, inguinal hernia and respiratory system examinations, lower or upper limb neurological examination. Important things to remember for all teaching stations: when you are introducing yourself to a medical student, do not use doctor and your surname. Always introduce yourself with your first name, and before teaching anything, first assess the knowledge of the student and explain those things which he doesn't know or which he wants to learn. Throughout the teaching stations, it is important to repeatedly check understanding. Almost after every step, remember to make sure to ask the student, "Are you following me? Is everything clear so far?" Interesting thing is that in Player 2 exam, you may have a hyperactive medical student who is moving here and there in the cubicle, or you may have to teach to an uninterested medical student who is just standing there, not participating actively. Your job is to engage that medical student, whether he is a hyperactive or an uninteresting student. Accordingly, you have to show your skills, how you engage a medical student when you are teaching something to them. Another important thing is to praise the student off and on. When you ask something and you get some answer, whether it is not completely correct, but at least you have to praise the student. And whenever making a correction, do not criticize or judge. Make a correction in a nice way. So these are the interpersonal skills and some important points about teaching stations. You can apply these skills in any teaching station. The best way to approach a teaching station is a RAPDA approach. I will discuss about RAPDA approach later. Today's teaching station is per speculum examination to a final year medical student. So as an example, I have chosen this station to demonstrate how we can deal with a teaching scenario. Coming to our RAPDA approach. What is RAPDA? R stands for RAPO. A stands for assess the knowledge. B stands for before starting the examination, you need to explain the procedure, steps involved, what position and exposure is required, and you have to offer privacy and chaperon, and you need to explain to the medical student what equipments we need and the contraindications to that particular examination should be excluded before. Then D stands for during. So what are the different steps and how we perform these steps? We need to explain everything to the medical student. And A stands for after. It means how to finish the examination. So this is RAPDA approach for teaching stations. Coming to RAPO building. As I mentioned earlier, you need to introduce yourself with your first name, and then you should say that, "Hello, Alex. I am," whatever your first name is, "one of the junior doctors in this department. How are you doing?" He may say, "I am very well, doctor. Thank you." Then ask, "How are your studies?" "My studies are going fine, doctor. You know, I am in final year. My exam is coming up soon. I am a bit stressed out." Say, "Alex, it's true. Exams are always stressful, especially the final year exam. We all have been through the same, but I am sure you will make it. Please don't worry too much about that. If you find anything difficult, I will be more than happy to help you understand." So this is the initial phase of your encounter. Next comes assess knowledge and explain about the examination. How do we assess knowledge? Alex, today we are going to perform a perspeculum vaginal examination. Do you know anything about it?
No, doctor, I have no idea. I am very bad at it. Could you please teach me?
Don't worry, I am going to teach you how to do a perspeculum examination and how to take a cervical smear. Do you know why we do perspeculum examination?
You might say, I think it is done to examine female reproductive organs.
Then praise.
Yes, you are absolutely right, Alex. We do perspeculum examination to look at the external and internal female reproductive organs for any abnormality. And during the examination, we do external examination and we look for any redness, swelling, any lesion, ulcers, or any discharge. And then we also palpate the abdomen. Internal examination includes palpation of the vulva and vaginal walls, examination of the cervix, assessing the size and position of the uterus, any adnexal tenderness, location of the cervix, and we also perform any appropriate swabs or take smears. Is that clear? And Alex, before starting the examination, we need to do certain things. So now I am going to explain these to you. First of all, for any examination, what we need to do before the examination, do you have any idea about that, Alex? Doctor, I think we need to greet the patient, then introduce ourselves first, and then confirm the identity of the patient.
Again, praise. Very good, Alex. It's very important to develop a good rapport with the patient. Anything else we need to do?
No idea, doctor.
Okay, Alex, we have to explain to our patient about the procedure, what we are going to do, and then the position and exposure required for the examination. And do you have any idea about the adequate exposure for this examination?
No, doctor.
Okay, so Alex, we need exposure from below the mid-chest. You know why? Because we also need to examine the abdomen. And Alex, it is also very important to ensure privacy and dignity of our patient, and to have a chaperone with us whenever we do an intimate examination, which means whenever we examine private parts of a patient or we do examination of the truncal area, we need to offer privacy and chaperone. And finally, and most importantly, we take consent from the patient. And once patient says, okay, you can proceed, then we can start our examination. Is that clear?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, do you have any idea about the position of the patient when having a perspeculum examination?
No, doctor.
Alex, the position of the patient should be lithotomy or modified lithotomy position. Let me tell you how we explain the advanced lithotomy position to the patient. We ask the patient to lie down on her back with knees bent, then to bring her heels as close as possible to the buttocks and let the legs fall apart to either side. Is everything clear so far? Please, Alex, if you have any doubt, ask me and I will explain it again. Okay, now Alex comes our preparation for the exam, for the examination. So what equipments we need for perspeculum examination? So Alex, we need this instrument. Show Costco's speculum to Alex. Alex, do you know what is it?
Yes, doctor, it is a speculum, but I forgot its name.
It's okay, Alex. You are right, this is a speculum. This is a plastic self-retaining speculum. It is called Costco's speculum. It has two blades which open like a jaw, and it also has a thumb nut or screw. It is self-retaining to allow us to perform our procedure and take samples easily. Sometimes we also use a metallic speculum. And other things we need for this examination include a lubricating gel, a pair of gloves, and an adjustable light source. Now coming to how we performed the examination exactly. So it is very important that we wash our hands. And now how do we hold this speculum? So Alex, the two blades should be between the index and the middle finger, and your thumb will be on the thumb screw, and thumb screw should be facing upward. And this is how we hold the speculum. Show to Alex how you are holding the speculum, and then ask Alex, do you want to give it a try?
Yes, of course, doctor.
Okay, so hand over the speculum to Alex and let him try. And if he is not doing it correctly, and if he is doing it partially
correctly, then tell him that you are almost right, Alex. Let me tell you again how exactly we hold it. So this is how you make corrections in a nice way. So Alex, before starting the examination, it is better to ask the patient to empty the bladder. And as I told you earlier, we should be in a sitting position during performing the examination. So now I am going to sit on the chair to show you the steps of perspeculum examination. Firstly, we need to do a quick abdominal examination to check for any redness, swelling, and tenderness. Then we inspect the external genitalia for hair growth, hair distribution, any redness, swelling, discharge, bleeding, polyps, or any other skin lesions. Another important thing to remember is that vaginal prolapse is a contraindication of perspeculum examination. To check for any prolapse, we ask the patient to cough and notice any mass coming down from the vagina. Is that clear, Alex? And before doing the rest of the examination, we need to be scrubbed and gloved. So assume I am scrubbed and gloved. And now we will proceed. And now I am going to show you how we introduce the speculum into the vagina. We set the light source to have a clear view of the internal genitalia. We take the speculum and we apply gel on it. Alex, could you please adjust the light source for me? This is a way to engage the medical student with you and with the examination. And he says, yes, okay, I'm going to adjust the light. And say thank you, Alex. So let's start. So with the left thumb and index finger, we spread the labia and warn the patient that she might feel a bit cold and a bit of discomfort as I am going to introduce the speculum. And the right way to introduce it is that the blade should be parallel to the slit. This is how we introduce the speculum gently. As you insert, go downwards while rotating the speculum upwards. Is that clear? And now with the left hand, tighten the screw so that the blades are opened up. Is that clear? Alex, you can see now it is self-retaining. So we can easily look inside the genitalia and up to the cervical os. Alex, would you like to have a look? Yes, doctor. Okay, come on and sit on the chair. Alex, can you tell me what you can see inside? Doctor, I can see a small opening. Yes, Alex. You know what it is? No, doctor. Alex, that is cervical os. Can you please tell me what shape it is? Doctor, it is circular. Yes, exactly. Circular opening means that the patient has not given birth vaginally. And if it is a slit-like opening, then it means the patient has given birth vaginally. Alex, do you understand the difference now? Yes, doctor. Okay. During perspeculum examination, you can see if there is any redness, discharge, any bleeding, any polyps, or any growth. And we can also take a pap smear. For pap smear, we have a special pap smear kit in which you have the brush, a special brush to take pap smear. But before that, we need to exclude any contraindication. Do you have any idea about the contraindications of pap smear? No, doctor. Don't worry, Alex, I will explain to you. Contraindication of pap smear are pregnancy, active vaginal bleeding, periods, recent use of spermicidal gel, and recent intercourse. If any of this condition is present, we do not take pap smear. And how do we take pap smear? Now I'm going to take the pap smear and you can watch. So take the brush and introduce it directly into the cervical os without touching anywhere else. Then turn it anti-clockwise 5 times and take it out and separate its tip and put it into the container and throw the handle into the waste bin. Then label the container and it will go to the laboratory. And the result comes back after 2 weeks. Now the examination is finished. Now how we remove the speculum? It is very important to remove the speculum in a proper way. So I am going to tell you how to remove the speculum. So can I have the chair, please? Alex, first withdraw the speculum a little bit so that blades do not snap on the cervix. And now we can unscrew the thumb nut. After that, we remove it exactly the same way as we introduced. And when we take it out, we check for any discharge or blood stain on the blades of the speculum. And then we throw the plastic speculum into the waste bin. If it were a metallic speculum, you would need to send it for sterilization. After the examination, don't forget to say thank you to the patient and offer tissues to wipe. and asking her to dress up in privacy. Alex, do you feel confident now about the per-speculum examination?
Yes, doctor. Thank you so much.
You are welcome, Alex. And see you again, and best of luck for your exams. So, right, guys, this is how we teach to a medical student. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to watch other PLAB2 videos on my YouTube channel and subscribe and press the bell icon for more interesting videos. And touch the like icon if you like this video and forward it to your friends. Thank you very much, and see you again with some more information. Thank you and bye-bye. Hello, guys.